I know it's, this just looks like Fat Boy Sweating in the Woods in summertime, but there's more going on here than that. There's that going on. There's also more going on. I'm standing at a little marker here on a property line that we had established. We've got 800 acres on the south side and about 600 acres here on the north side that we've got under contract. And so this track on the behind me on the north side is selling. And we need to establish a property line through here for the remaining 800 acres. I had a surveyor come in and establish this line on paper. And he's just left a few minutes ago, but he's marked the corners. He marked the corners on the west end, and he marked the corner on the east end here. Those corners are set. Only a surveyor can establish corners. He pinned those corners. They're in the ground forever. I also had him then come follow me around in the on the four-wheeler there, and I went up and down different trails on this property. I knew where all the trails are, and wherever that property line hit these established trails, a main road and these trails, I had him shoot these spots to find that line where it hit these trails. Here's the actual survey stake right here. And he did this in 6 or 8 different spots, including a food plot over on the east side. Now he's come and gone. He did that in just less than an hour, established all these, I call them midpoints. It's not exactly the right term because there's 6 or 8 of them and they're not equidistant from corner to, you know, corner to corner. They're just in different intervals across this line, wherever the line hits a road. So he's did this in less than an hour. I'm coming back now and I'm putting these T-posts wherever these survey stakes are. I'm standing on the east side of the trail. If you could see, there's a T-post just like this right there on the west side of the trail that I put in the ground, put flagging on it. And these steel T-posts will be here till Jesus comes. They're permanent. These wooden stakes are going to get knocked over. Bears are going to come rub on these in this part of the country. These wooden stakes are going to be gone. So, but these metal T-posts are here. There's 6 or 8 of them, like I said, across here. This is rugged, rugged ground, a bottomland hardwood track. People are not going to be roaming across these property lines and getting off of their property on somebody else. They're basically going to be using these trails with four-wheelers and rangers, that sort of thing. And they're going to easily see when they're coming to the property line because they're going to be flagged T-posts on both sides. What a person can then do if they'd like, wherever these T-posts are, and they're scattered out here, like I say, there's counting the corners and all of these markers along the way, there are 8 or 10 of these established points. They could come over about 4,000 feet. They could come through here with a, like I'm using, a compass or hire a forester, and can simply just flag from point to point along here and wouldn't have to go very far from point to point. And put down posts or paint trees to establish a complete permanent boundary line. That's not really necessary, but if somebody wanted to do that, and everybody's got a different, you know, preference for that sort of thing, it's doable. To have the surveyor, however, blaze this line from the east side to the west side over 4,000 feet through this country would have been $15,000 to $20,000 just for blazing this line. I'm just pulling a number out of my ear, but I'm going to be close if I'm not way under. It's expensive, and there's no reason to do that unless a person's building a fence or they're going to have structures right along this line somewhere. To know precisely where the property line is out in the middle of that slough within a foot just doesn't make much sense. But to have a general idea of where the property line is because you flagged it in yourself, and you have a general idea of where to put deer stands, where to put duck blinds, that sort of thing, it's so much more economical. It just makes good sense. So don't shy away from having survey work done to establish corners and to then get, you know, a few midpoints put in that line somewhere. Then you come in and do the work. A little bit of work on your part save you thousands of dollars on the survey side. If it's a rural remote recreational property like this, a roughed in property line like this with the corners well marked and the trails well marked is all you really need. It'll save you a bunch of money. It'll keep your neighbors happy, keep you happy, keep people off of your land, keep you from wandering on somebody else's. And it just works out really well that way. I put in several of these already. I think I've got one more main road to do and one more food plot. So another 30 minutes, I'll have this project done and we'll have a great boundary line separating 800 acres and 600 acres. And when I go, when I show this 800 acres, I'll be able to get on these trails and ride people through these, this beautiful bottomland hardwood track. And so when we hit these, hit this flagging right here, hit this, these T-posts on any of these trails, the buyer will have an instant, absolutely be able to recognize, here's the property line. It sinks in their head. They understand that the track is well marked. It just all sort of fits together and makes sense, as opposed to saying, well, the line is somewhere out there somewhere. I can point to something and give them a frame of reference, and it burns it in their minds, and they have a good understanding, and people appreciate that. So if I don't get snake bit or melt out here in this humidity, I'll get this done and move on.